Hey Charmers, it's Gato from the social team here, and today I'm going to be showing you how to clean and disinfect your eyeshadow palettes as well as other powdered products in a way that will not alter the formula, but make sure that everything is super squeaky clean and safe to use. You'll just need a couple things to get started. First, of course, you'll need a well-loved, well-used eyeshadow palette. You can also use this trick on single color compacts such as bronzers or highlighters or blushes, but I'm specifically showing you eyeshadow palettes today. Next, you'll need a pretty common household item, Q-tips. Don't worry, you don't need one for every color, just a couple will do. Next up, you'll need some tissues, or if you have a dark colored rag that you don't mind getting eyeshadow or powder product on, you're more than welcome to use that as well. Last but certainly not least, you'll need some high-proof sprayable alcohol. This here is 91, but some beauty stores and pharmacies sell as high as 99% sprayable alcohol. The higher proof you can get your hands on, the better, but 91 is pretty fine. So to get started, I'm gonna take my eyeshadow palette, as you can see here, very well loved. And I'm actually going to do some swatches to show you guys the difference before and after you spray in the pigmentation. So I'm gonna take some Terracotta from the Violet Boss Essentials palette. One of my favorite colors, as you can see, very well used. Here's swatch one. I'm gonna take some Dusty Rose, which is also a matte. Here is swatch two. See those two swatches. And then I'm gonna take Emerald, which is a shimmer. I'm gonna put it right there. Can you see those? So I'm gonna take my palette. I'm gonna hold it as far away from me as possible, but at least about a foot or so. And then I'm just gonna spray away. Don't be shy about how much alcohol you get in the powder itself. In fact, you wanna try and get them very highly saturated so that you really, really get as much of the bacteria and the oil that's piled up on the powders as possible. And you'll see it dries really quickly. You'll then wanna take your tissues and just clean up around the edges of the colors themselves. You wanna get in between and around, really try and get the palette as clean as possible. This last step is optional, but if you really, really, really want to make sure that you get all of the powder, especially for you makeup artists out there that are using these palettes on several people, you want to just kind of douse your Q-tip in some alcohol. And then you can take some of the more loved colors and sort of start to clean the edges here. Really get in there. And again, like I said, you can use the same Q-tip on several colors just by moving it around here. Last little tidy up here, just kind of get some of the extra after you cleaned the corners of some of the other colors. And that's it. Your powders are disinfected and free of bacteria and oil. Now, remember, I took Terracotta, Dusty Rose, and Emerald. Right next to them, I'm gonna do Terracotta, Dusty Rose, and Emerald. So as you can see here, the colors did not alter in formula. They still give off the same great pigmentation, but now they're clean, they're safe to use on other people. If you're a really great friend and you're doing your friend's makeup, or if you're a professional in the industry and you have several clients in a day, you now know how to make sure that your palette is squeaky clean, bacteria free, safe to use, safe to put on the face, and ready for you to slay the day. If you love this video, make sure you give it a big thumbs up and make sure you subscribe to the BoxyCharm channel for more tips, tricks, unboxings, product reveals. Really, the list goes on. Till next time, Charmers.